you know, your kind of, can I say, Jack the Lad?
Yes, faux soldier.
bit of a geezer.
Yeah.
how did you get on with Alan Sugar?
Do you know what? He's a lovely, lovely man. Obviously, when I'd done The Apprentice, I ain't like a normal person that goes on The Apprentice. And I'm a market trader from Romford. That's what I've always done. Went on the show. Really, really enjoyed it. I found it like enjoyable. But when I was talking to Alan, like he's a genuine person, you know. He's not. He comes across on that screen like a really scary guy. But when you actually talk to him in person, one to one, he's a top bloke and he give you advice.
But he still got rid of you.
He still sacked me. You know what I mean? He still fired you
for not being diligent, not completing tasks on time.
I lost every task, didn't I, Nigel? I was pony on there, let's be honest. I was absolutely pony.
And yet, afterwards, Sugar said, after he sacked you, Sugar said that you were the kind of man you'd want to have with you in the trenches at war. So he was still quite nice about you.
Lovely, wasn't it? Yeah.
So talk to us about the word bosh.
Do you know what? Right, so I didn't even know I said the word bosh until I went on The Apprentice. And it's just a word that we've always said, you know, bosh. Like, it's just, you know, I don't know, I say bosh. I don't know where it comes from. But as soon as I went on The Apprentice, obviously picked up, I say it about 400 times a day. And when it went on the telly, it became a trend. Everyone started saying bosh all the time, like. And it was madness. And now I've named my business Bosch Beds after the word. Like, I'm Bosch Global. I've got a couple of Bosch companies.
Even Bosch Golf Club.
The Bosch Drive. I'm on the shopping channel twice a week, selling my own golf club. I'm making a living out of the word bosh, which ain't too sad.
That's your